how to create freelancer portfolio in Upwork. That is what we are going to talk about in this video. Hi there, my name is Sadiq Umar. I am a full-time freelancer living in Nigeria. And in this video, I'm going to show you step-by-step how you can set up a freelancer account in Upwork. I will start from the very basic steps up to the moment where you will complete your profile and you will have a profile that is ready to start sending proposals to start applying for jobs on Upwork. Without any delay, let's jump to my computer and I will show you step by step how you can create a freelancer account in Upwork and start applying for jobs. In order to create an account in Upwork, the first thing you need is you need to have an email address. And if you already have a Gmail account, you can just sign into your Gmail account. If you don't have a Gmail account, it's very easy to set up a Gmail account. So the first thing you need to do is set up a Gmail account. Once you create your Gmail account, the next step is to log into your Gmail account. It will look like this. And then you open another tab. You go to Upwork.com. Then you click sign up. Then you choose I am a freelancer looking for work and apply as a freelancer. You fill in the details with your correct details, your first name, your last name, your email address, you choose a password. Then you choose your country. And when setting up an account in Upwork, it's very important not to use a VPN. Make sure to not use a VPN and choose your correct country. Upwork doesn't have any requirement as to what country you have to be in order to sign up. You can sign up from any country in the world. So you make sure you choose the country you are currently living in and don't use a VPN. This is optional. You can leave it on or not if you want. And you have to agree to Upwork terms and condition, so you have to select this one and create my account. Okay, once you submit the form, the first thing you need to do is you verify your email address. And the way to do that is they are going to send a verification email to your Gmail account, the Gmail account that you provided, in my case this Gmail account. So you just go back to the Gmail account and you will receive an email from Upwork. The email will look like this. So you open the email address, and you click verify email. And that's it. Congratulations, your account is verified. You can close this tab. Okay, the next thing that you need to do is to follow the steps that are listed below. And to do that, you click get started. Have you freelanced before? That means, are you a freelancer already? Have you been working as a freelancer? If no, then you choose I am a brand new to this and go to next. What is your biggest goal? To earn your main income, to make money on the side, to get experience for a full-time job. And if you don't have a goal, then you choose this one. And I am guessing to earn my main income is going to be probably your objective. So we choose that and go to next. And how will you like to work? I suggest you start with I would like to find my opportunities, to find opportunities myself instead of creating a package. So you choose this one. And you select I am open to contract to hire opportunities and go to next and create profile. How would you like to tell us about yourself? What this means is how would you like to introduce yourself? How would you like to add your description, your profile image and so on? You can import from your LinkedIn profile or upload your resume, but I suggest you do it manually. So you start by adding your title. That is what are you going to do as a freelancer. For this profile, we are going to do data entry. So we are going to foreign data entry and go to next. This is where you add your portfolio. If you previously work before, whether you had a full-time job or you work as a freelancer or any experience that you have, this is where you start adding your experience. And we'll see how it looks. So you add the title, your job title, the company you work for, location, and whether you are currently working here or whether you stop working there, and you add the description of the job you previously had. And if you don't have any previous experience, you leave it empty and add your education. I'm sorry, skip for now. And right here you add your education and click save. If you have another certification that you want to add, you just click the plus here and add another certification. If you don't have, you go to add next. And this is where you choose your English level of proficiency. I suggest you choose fluent. If you aren't fluent in English, you need to be fluent in English. So choose fluent. And if you have any other languages that you want to add, you just click add a language and add your language right here. Then you go to next, add your skills. Okay, so the best way to do this is to start typing and you'll see suggestions. So you choose from there. We do data entry. We are going to see data analysis. We can do Excel. So this is how you add all your relevant skills. For this profile, I'm setting up a profile for a data entry freelancer. So I'll try and think of all the things that are included in data entry. Usually when doing data entry, you are going to be using a Microsoft Excel, PowerPoint, Microsoft Word. So these are all the tools that you can add as your skills. So we think of any relevant skill, you can add up to 15 skills. So we think of any other skill that you want to add right here that is relevant to what you are going to start selling as a freelancer. And when you start typing, it will just appear right here. So you click on it and you add it at your, you add it as your skills. When you finish, you go to next, right, an overview. Okay, so what this means is, they explain it right here. Help people get to know you at a glance. What work you are best at, tell them clearly using a paragraph or bullet point. You can always edit later, just make sure you proofread now. So what this means is, you write your introduction, what you do, how you do it, who you serve, and any other relevant information that will help people when they visit your profile. At a first glance, they will see what you do and understand what you are offering. And this is an example right here. This is an example of a web developer introduction. He explained clearly what he is and even included a bullet point of the services that he is offering. And another way to do this is to go to Upwork again in a private window and search for other freelancers and search for the skill that you are going to start selling. In this case, we are going to do data entry. And these are some of the top freelancers that are offering data entry services. You can see right here, top rated. So what you can do is, you can open their profile. And you can see how they set up their profile. So you can just check out the top rated freelancers and see how they write their introduction, and you can take inspiration from there. Don't copy their profile, but just take inspiration from there. For the sake of this video, I'm going to do this. And you can also use AI to make it better. If you know ChatGPT, I know probably know ChatGPT. So you can just copy this description that you already wrote and you go to ChatGPT. I'm going to show you an example. You copy it. Then you go to ChatGPT and you use a prompt like, make this introduction better, and you paste the intro that you just wrote, and ChatGPT is going to try and rewrite it and make it better for you. Perfect. So make sure you just go through it, you read, make sure everything is correct, then you can just copy your introduction. You go back to Upwork and you paste it right here. You make sure the formatting is correct and everything is correct. Make sure you read it carefully, and because AI sometimes make mistake, so make sure to go through it carefully and make sure there is no mistake. When you finish with your introduction, you go to next, choose your categories. So this is where you choose all the services that you are going to start offering. When you click this here, a drop down will open. And you can find all the services that you can sell as a freelancer on Upwork, and you will choose any service that is relevant to you. For me right here, the suggested one is good because we are setting off a data entry profile, and this is data entry and transcription services. So I'm just going to click and add it. And we can go to next, set your rate. So right here is not very important, because when you start communicating with client, that is when you are going to set a rate and agree on a rate for any specific project. But right here, you can just set a placeholder. You can just do $10. That is an hourly rate. So you can just choose whatever you want to set as your hourly rate. And when you choose, you go to next, add your photo and location. And your location is already set right here. Street address won't show in your profile, so you just write your street address at 69. You add your phone number. And you add your profile photo. Okay, when adding your profile photo, it's very important to add a photo that clearly show your face, clearly show your smiling face, and if possible, try to avoid adding any photo that has too much noise in the background. If you have a photo that has too much noise in the background, you can try to remove the background or take another picture that show clearly your face. And you do attach photo and you go to check your profile. Okay, right here you can go through your profile and read, make sure everything is correct before you submit your profile. Your photo is right here, the languages you speak are right here, you read your description, and your hourly rate. Your hourly rate is not that important because, as I said, you are going to set a rate when you start communicating with client. For any project, you are going to agree on a specific amount that the client is going to pay you before you do any project. So this is just like a placeholder. These are the skills that I have added. You can customize if you want. If you have any work experience, you can add it right here. This is my education. You can customize this also. And when you are confident everything is correct, you go to submit profile. And that's it. Your profile is completed. You can just go to view my profile and you will see your profile on Upwork. You completed your freelancer profile on Upwork. Now you are a freelancer on Upwork. And you can see right here, this is how your profile looks like in Upwork. If you want to see how it looks to client, you can click right here, see public view. And this is how a client is going to see your profile when they visit your profile. They are going to see your name, your picture, your service, what you are offering, your hourly rate, your description, your skills, your education. This is exactly what a client will see if they visit your profile. And you can make any changes you want to your profile anytime you want. But this is how you set a profile in Upwork. When you finish this step, you have a live profile on Upwork and you are a freelancer on Upwork. As you can see, this is all the steps that you need to follow in order to set up an account in Upwork and start applying for jobs, start sending proposals, and start your freelancing career. Like I always say, in order to become a successful freelancer, you have to have enough patience to keep developing your skills, to develop your profile, to build your portfolio, and that is the only way for you to become a successful freelancer. If you enjoy the video, please give it a like. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.